Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Hallelujah. Let's stand to our feet. And I just want to worship the Lord of Lords.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the King of Kings.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, for his worship. He's worthy to be worshipped.
Yes.
Amen. He's worthy to be praised.
Amen.
One thing is sure is his name.
Yes.
The name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow. There is no name under heaven which man may be saved, but through the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And I want you to focus on that this morning. Focus on the name. His name is Jesus. Can you say that with me? Say Jesus.
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 Jesus. The man that died just for you. The name Jesus. The blood that was shed just for you. Jesus. You can't say that name and nothing happens. Something happens every time you call on him. Say Jesus.
Jesus.
You know when you're drowning and you raise your hands and say, help, help. That's the same thing the name of Jesus does. It gets his attention. If you say Jesus in the midst of your circumstances and situation, I promise he'll answer. Jesus. 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 Mighty Jesus. Jesus. Deliverer Jesus. The man that loves you when nobody else could. The unconditional love of Jesus. Oh, Jesus. 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 You can whisper his name in the midnight hour. Jesus. He hears you and he answers. Jesus. Deliverer Jesus. Healer Jesus. Lover of my soul. Jesus. 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 There's power in the name of Jesus. Must flee. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Mighty, mighty, mighty power. Jesus. 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 There's power. Jesus. Jesus. Do you really understand the name? Do you understand the weaponry of the name of Jesus? Oh, Jesus. 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 A lot of people say, I don't know the word like that. Can you call on Jesus? If you call him, he'll show up. If you call him, he'll answer. Jesus. Every demon must flee. Every demonic power comes subject to the name of Jesus. The Bible said he went down to hell. He took the keys and he gave me the power to bind the devil. When they hear the name of Jesus, 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 the anointed one, Jesus, Jesus. You see, I said, why you keep calling? Because I'm waiting for something just to just break loose. Jesus, I believe I called him long enough, something gonna happen. It ain't got the choice but to happen. Jesus, there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. Jesus, I want that the thing become rhema to you. I want it to become real to you. I want you to really keep this down in your belly, in your soul. I want you to understand what I'm saying today. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Well, you're at the end of your rope. You don't know which way to go or what to do. He said he's a leader. Make your decisions in your life. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, he's the lover of your soul. I'm lonely. Jesus. He's the lover of my soul. Jesus. Oh, my God. He entangles and arrests me. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. 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 Lover of my soul. Lover of my soul. Lover of souls. Can you call it this morning? Call it Jesus.
Jesus.
I need you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Come on, say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. He's your doctor. He's your Lord. Hey, he's everything. See, we got the 4-in-1, the facts, the scale, and all that. He's all in one. He's the total package. The total package. The total package. See, you don't need anything else. Once you got him, you got it all. You don't need the extra. Everything else is just extra. But you got the total package. You got the total package. He's everything that you want him to be. You need him to be. Jesus. 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 Everything that you need him to be. Everything that you want him to be. I know the time of trouble. I'm gonna tell the tip of the cross. When something come up, you stop your talk. But oh my God, when it's down on the inside, I'm here to tell you, when things happen, my first reaction is Jesus. Because it's down on the inside. Jesus. It should be such a response that you invoke a response of Jesus. And at that very moment, at that very instant, what you want, daughter? What you want, son? I'm here. Your babies. Jesus on his way. He's running at 80. Ready to assist you.
Amen.
You got to remember that.
Amen.
You got to remember the unconditional love. The man that went to the cross just for you.
Amen.
The man that bled and died just for you. Even when you didn't deserve it, he did it anyway. That same man. He took the stripes on his back just for you. He bled just for you so that you can be healed. So you can walk in him. Jesus did. Jesus did. You don't have to be sick in your body. You don't have to be bound. You can be delivered. Why? Because of Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus. 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 Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Just lift your hands. Just lift your hands before the Lord. Just lift your hands. And just listen.
Jesus.
Deliverer, Jesus. Savior, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Healer, Jesus. Lover of my soul, Jesus. I want you to dwell on the name of Jesus and let him continue to do that for you. I want you to always exalt him. He's the one that can move for you when nobody else can. Amen.
So many people here love Jesus.
Okay.
Yes. All right.
There you go.
Let's go.
Yes. the Jesus in me, love the Jesus in you. It's so easy. It's so easy. It's so easy. So easy to love.
Yeah. All right.
Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
As my sister had said, Lord, I pray that the numbers of times that we call out on your name is more than the numbers that we just, Lord, use your name when we're in trouble.
Come on. Yes.
I pray, Lord Jesus,
yes.
that it's your name we speak when we're elated and excited
yes.
and celebrating.
Yes.
Yes.
I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord.
Yes.
I thank you for the spirit of gratitude that is in this house this morning. God, I thank you for all these babies that are in the house.
Yes.
And Lord Jesus, I thank you, Lord God, that sometimes we need a quickening and a reminder, Lord God. Because, Lord God, a lot of folks would seek to keep the babies quiet. But yet, Lord God, your word proclaims that, Lord, a child shall lead them.
Yes.
And so, Lord, let us be ever ready to listen. Listen. Watch the play of a child and get unrestricted ourselves when we worry about what everybody else thinks. Lord, help us to play as a child. Help us to open our hearts as a child, Lord, to be trusting of you, God.
Yes.
Work that work back in us. Because somehow, somewhere along the way, we forgot
yes.
to trust you like a child.
Yes.
Lord God, work that work in us today. And Lord, before we even begin up in this house today, Lord, sometimes folks wait on the altar call. Lord God, they wait on that invitation.
Right.
Lord, and they can't even hear the word. They can't even hear the message. They can't even sing the song. They can't even pray the prayer. They can't even give the tithe. They can't even give the gift. They can't even show up in their own bodies while they're sitting here in worship, Lord God, because they're waiting
yes, Jesus.
On that altar call.
Yes, Jesus.
But God, today I say if the altar call never comes,
yes.
if you choose to come right here, right now,
yes.
we are ready.
Yes.
We are ready.
Yes.
We are ready. If there be anybody in the house that something is blocking you from receiving the word or from giving praise this morning, you know who you are, you know the situation, you know what's worked in your heart, you know what's been in your spirit, you've been carrying it around all night, you've been carrying it around all morning, you brought it into last week, and and last year, and you said, oh, when January 1st gets here, we're going to make a New Year's resolution, and we're going to trust God for another year. How about trusting God now?
Yes.
Now. If there's a need in the house, lift your hand, just say now. Now. You got to create that landing strip. Now. Now. You know, we ask God for things, but we're over yonder, and we're over yonder. We're talking to that one, and that one back there. Create a landing strip.
Yes.
Now, don't wait on some altar call. It may not come. Okay? Because Agape is full of the Holy Ghost. And you never know when y'all just going to be, whoo.
Come on.
Amen.
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 Amen. Create that landing. You need a healing? Anybody need a healing in their body? Yeah. See, as a result, you need a healing in your body. Just receive it.
That's it.
Just receive it. You know, we have these long, drawn-out services. And we beg God to do this, and we beg God to do that. I don't know what Bible you're using,
yeah.
but mine says ask and receive.
That's what it says.
Yeah.
That's what it says.
Ask now.
That's Okay, maybe not y'all, but other people. So y'all can teach them how to do this, right? Because we make things so complicated. Well, you know, you got to read this and that and the other, and you got to pray this and that and the other, and you got to go here this and that and the other. How about now?
Yes.
Oftentimes.
Yes.
Okay, again, we're talking about other people, not y'all. Okay. Oftentimes, we sit and we listen to the burdens of folks, and we're just like, oh, yeah, sister. Oh, oh, yeah, you got it bad.
Yes.
I thought I had it bad, but you got it bad. Right? We need this plan and that plan, and you need to read this book and listen to that and do all that. How about the possibility that the very next time, which I'm trusting going to happen before you probably walk out of this building or this very day, that someone expresses a need and you say, no!
Yes.
Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Lord Jesus.
Yes.
You're a now kind of God.
Yes.
Hebrews 11 1 says, now faith. Now faith. Not tomorrow, not Tuesday, not Thursday, not Saturday morning, 9 o'clock, not on hangover on Sunday. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. But Lord Jesus, now.
Now.
You said now faith.
Yes, God.
And Lord, we're believing in a now faith.
Yes.
A now faith.
Yes.
Lord God, right now. Lord, we're not greedy prayers. We're not greedy worshipers. Lord, right now, if there be a need in someone else's life, as we stand here in faith, in proxy, heard one sister needs lifting her dad up. In proxy, we need, you got some need right now. Someone in your family, a friend, a co-worker, a fellow student, whatever the issue, right now. Be there now for them right now. Lift them up right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Speak their name in your heart right now. Right now and say now.
Now.
Now, God. Now. Seal that. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sit down, y'all. Praise the Lord, church. We're excited to be back in Savannah. Excited to be at Agape. Yes, yes, I bring greetings to you from my amazing, I used to say partner, but my amazing wife, Pamela. Yeah. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your congratulations and all your joy. You posted back and all that. You guys are amazing. I love y'all. Love y'all. We bring greetings from California, Pamela Ministries. We love you guys. I'm excited for your pastor, Elder Erica, and the new addition to their family. I can't wait to see what God's going to do. I can't wait. I mean, God's already done. You know what I'm saying? It's time for us to catch up. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Right? I'm excited about what God is doing. I praise God, y'all. I can't help but give a shout out to the Lord. Because you know, some things don't make sense. Some things really don't make sense in the natural. Because if things are in the natural and they always made sense, what are we going to trust God for?
Right.
Right? What do we need to trust God for? Oh, Pastor P, I got this degree. Hey, I got this experience.
And?
I got, you don't know my name. You don't know who I know. But some things just don't make sense. You know, how you gonna get a truck? You know what I mean? And my sister shared that it's like it don't make sense in the natural. But God.
But God.
But God. How's your body gonna be healed and whole? You know, you get the blood work back and it's healed and whole, and you're looking at yourself in the mirror and go, hey,
yeah.
But God.
But God.
Okay? See, and if you don't get anything else out of today, there's a sermon in there somewhere, but if you don't get anything else out of today, know that God is a now God.
Yes, He is.
God is a right on time, now God. Okay?
Yes.
We're in an interesting season in this nation.
Right.
I got two words for you. But God.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
But God. A lot of folks fearful, afraid of all this stuff, you know. Fear not.
Fear not.
Amen.
Fear not.
Yes.
Okay? Fear not. Whatever the outcome, fear not. Fear not. But God. Okay? All I can urge you to do his vote. I have, in the last year, I guess, see all these documentaries and Netflix movies and things like that, the things that folks went through that we could vote.
That's right.
Okay? I'm just going to put that right there. People have died for the privilege to vote. People have died for our privilege to vote. So vote, okay? That's all we're going to say about that. All right? It's an exciting time in our nation. I'm excited, one and foremost, about who God is.
Amen.
Because I don't care what the vote is,
amen,
God is still large and in control.
Amen.
Large and in charge. Amen? Amen? Well, I want to share a message with you today that, I mean, you know how God works. You think you're going to do one thing, and God like twists it up on you, you know, and you're all ready. I mean, you fly 3,000 miles and you sitting on go, and you know, I'm like, I got the word. Yeah, here it comes. Here it comes. Okay, about halfway there, it's like, no, you ain't got the word. I got the word.
Amen.
Okay? And so God began to stir my heart and gave me this little image about, because I kept thinking about this, how we go, we love horseback riding, that's our thing. Horseback riding, camping, great outdoors, all that kind of stuff. Okay, so horseback riding, when we're horseback riding, you know, when y'all think of California, I don't know if folks have been, anybody been to California? Well, when this Florida girl went to California, it was going to be all about the pictures that I had seen. I pictured beaches and palm trees. Okay, and nice breeze blowing off the water.
Yeah.
Right? Honey, it's hot. It is desert hot, mountainous, sandy hot. Okay? So much of our horseback riding is done in the desert hot place where cactus and creatures jump out of rocks that you can't even say their name when you try to look them up, you know what I mean? Very multiple syllables of things. And there's all these cactus. We're riding on the trail, okay? Every now and then you get trees, you get a little, you know, canopy of trees over you. And as horseback riders, out of respect for one another, and you just don't want somebody to fall off or the horse to go crazy, you point out things along the way. Oh, low branch. Everybody's riding their horse. Right? You say, you see a cactus, you're coming up on a cactus, you're trying to get your horse to tiptoe around that cactus to miss it, right? Okay, and then you got cactus on both sides. So you're trying to think skinny thoughts for you and your horse. You're gonna pass through the cactus so that neither one of you catch that thing or that thing catch you. But we're continually pointing these little hazards along the way out to one another. And what God pricked my heart is why don't we do that anyway? Why don't we do that on a daily basis with each other?
Amen.
Why don't we, when we know we've been somewhere, we've been on that trail, and that trail's got a lot of cactus to the right, you want to ride to the left.
Uh-huh.
Whenever there's going to be a water crossing about a quarter mile down, and then whenever you cross that water, you want to get in on the left-hand side because there's going to be a big dip on the right, and so you and your horse can pass safe there. You want to left. We tell each other these things.
Yes.
But oftentimes we don't do that with one another on a daily basis.
Right.
We let each other go through some stuff.
Come on now.
And we think we're doing them a favor.
Okay. Preach the word.
Oftentimes because we don't want to admit we went through it too. Right? Oftentimes we want to be all boastful and prideful. I got this. Well, you got this because you've been through that.
Amen.
You know, I love it when, okay, you go to even meet someone, you know, or you're going into some place, you know when it's not safe.
That's it.
Right.
You know when it's not safe. But yet, too often we're like, you go in ahead of me, I got your back. Go ahead. You tell them hello, I'll be right there. Right? Oftentimes, We, remember other people, not y'all, we lead folks into places that God never purposed for them because we didn't say nothing. We didn't speak the warning. We didn't speak the, not to instill fear, don't get it twisted, don't get it wrong. Not to instill fear, but love somebody enough to guard them from some stuff. Because I don't know about you, but I'm thankful that God has protected me from some things. Why? Because somebody else pointed out and said, ooh, you don't want to go in there, that's a bee. Get up out of there. You don't want to go down that path. You don't want to go in that muddy water. You don't want to do that. So I'm thankful for those times, okay? Because I want you to just kind of think about this for just a second. Have you ever had anybody say, ooh, I got your back, baby, don't worry, I got your back. Anybody else ever experienced that? Oh, I got your back. I got your back. Well, you, isn't it kind of a funny sort of thing when somebody says, I got your back? Monica, come here for just a second. Monica, don't worry. Don't worry. Don't worry. I got your back. I got your back. I got your back. I got your back. I got your back, Monica. It's all right. It's all right. Right? And she's going in ahead. She's going to have to deal with everything ahead because I got your back. Right? Isn't that how it usually is? That put a visual to that thing, huh? Pay attention to that next time somebody says they got your back when they're back here doing this business. Okay? If somebody's really got your back, I got your back.
Yeah.
I got your back. I got your back.
Yeah.
Okay? You know who's doing this.
Yes.
And who's doing the other.
Right?
Right?
Yep.
Thank you, Mom. It's important. It's important to pay attention to those things. Okay? In this next season, next dispensation, this next, we're in the end times.
Yes, we are.
Okay, if you didn't know we were, okay, here's Pastor Pico. Come to California and tell you, we in the end times, y'all.
Yeah.
You're wondering what's happening? A lot of people stuck to the news wondering at what's happened. It's already been told in the good book. It's already been told. And if you read this, you already know. And so when you got somebody's back, you know what you're looking for.
Right.
Wars and wars and rumors of wars.
Yeah.
Separation between families.
Yes.
Okay? Okay?
Yes.
The enemy is a liar.
Yes.
Seeking to kill, steal, and destroy.
Yes.
Ain't changed his plans in forever.
Yes.
You know his strategy. You know what to do. Praise God?
Yes.
Praise God.
Praise
now, I don't know who that fits or what that works. Now here's a sermon. See, in that place, when we're protecting others, protecting ourselves, sometimes it's the cactus, it's the thorns of life. We let folks take them thorns, right? And it's kind of like we, even in ourselves, okay, I'm just going to talk about us now, all right? In ourselves, because we've been hit so many times with the issues of life, okay, and we've got thorns all over, sometimes those thorns become comfortable.
Uh-huh.
I know where it is. I know how it feels. I got this.
Yeah.
Right.
I may not have that over there, but I got this, okay? And we end up being a walking hot mess.
Yes.
Okay? When it becomes familiar, it becomes comfortable. Don't talk about my thorn. Don't talk about my thorn.
Come on.
Right.
Right.
Right? Because it's familiar, we know what to do with this thorn or that thorn. Okay? And we get so used to it that we forget God didn't put it there.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Come on.
God didn't put it there. We got it going on a trail maybe we didn't supposed to go on, and we didn't listen to the warning.
Come on.
Yeah.
Okay? And so in these thorns, if we ever address the thorns, it's one thing to pull it out. Like even when a horse is injured and it gets thorns in its legs or whatever, and you go to pull it out, you got to do some doctrine.
Yes.
Okay? If you're going to pull it out to the root, you got to help the horse. The horse can't run over to Walgreens or where, all right? Okay? Well, maybe it could. I don't know. But you need to help it. In that same way, we need to get to the root of some stuff. Because if you don't pull that thorn out by the root, it will forever. It gives you pain, right? Every time it brushes against something even so light. And sometimes our hurt or our past or things that somebody barely touch it. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And it becomes a major ordeal.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because it still hurts. It's still tender.
Yeah.
Okay? And then we find ourselves wrapped in fear with the thorn still on the inside. I don't want to go there. I don't want to trust this. I don't want to do that. I don't want to do what I'm called to do by God because I might get hurt. I don't want
to. Ho, ho, ho.
It's like he said. Because I don't want to get hurt.
That's it.
And we wrap ourselves in this fear, and fear begins to block our hearts from trusting, from obedience.
Yes.
You know, ooh, I got burned financially from somewhere over yonder somewhere, so I'm not trusting these people, not with my money.
Come on now.
I work too hard for it as my money.
Mm-hmm.
Not trust. So you don't trust. So fear blocks our heart from being open to giving what God has, one, called us to do, and entrusted us to do. Okay? And so we get these heart blockages. Okay, we got any medical folks in the room? We got nurses and all kinds of folks. Oh, yeah. What a blessing. What a blessing. What happens when a heart, the arteries start getting blocked and hardened, right? Right? And it begins to block life. You're rolling along and all of a sudden here's a pain. Right? And we got one or two choices. We can either recognize it or ignore it. What happens if you ignore it?
It gets worse.
The backup gets worse. The plaque begins to build. Okay, what if we got this little doubt? We start ignoring it. Doubt begins to grow. Now we got some big doubt. Doubt leads to fear. Now we got some big fear. Here we're walking around like this fear time bomb, right?
Right.
Full of doubt, full of fear, full of worry. Oh yeah, praise Jesus! Putting on our Sunday school face. Right? And we're packed full of fear. And we're packed full of doubt. And we got on our Sunday school face. Praise the Lord.
Come on.
Bless Jesus, y'all.
Yes.
Right? But we got all this stuff. How about the possibility of praising and worshiping Jesus free?
Yes.
Without any of that stuff.
Yes.
Okay, when we consider, if we look at a heart that is blocked or arteries that begin to get blocked, the life source, it makes it hard, right?
Yes.
Okay, any medical people, please correct me if I start steering in the wrong direction. If it's blocked, it's time. We got to get in there and open that thing up.
Yes.
To let all that stuff through, right? I guess in a heart it would be plaque, right? Stuff.
Correct.
Okay? We don't like to think about these things. Sometimes we need open heart surgery from a faith perspective.
Right.
Because things have gotten so hardened in there.
Oh, wow.
Right?
That's right,
yes.
And we don't want, we stop. We want the blessings of God. Especially we don't want the blessings. We want the blessings of God. And God's just pouring out blessings, but we can't receive it.
That's it.
Because our heart is blocked with fear and doubt. And God knows what you got.
Come on.
God knows what you got in the bank.
Yeah.
God knows who you've been with, where you've been, what you've done.
Yes, he does.
There ain't nothing about you. Nothing. Not even that thing.
Hey.
You've been hiding from everybody else and yourself, but not from God. I'm just telling you. I'm just saying. God knows it's there. Okay? And sometimes we need a Holy Ghost angioplasty, right?
Right.
To get in there and open up that artery so that the life force can flow through.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
You with me?
Come on, man.
Now, not being a medical sort of person, I had to look. when God dropped angioplasty in my heart, I was like, Lord, I don't even know how to spell it. Let me see what all that means. I've heard it. I know what it is, but what's involved? Ooh, dog, you don't want one of those. Amen. You want it because you want the life force to come through, but that's some serious stuff. Okay? Because the way in which it works with a stent, we need a stent of faith, y'all.
Yeah.
Put into that blocked artery. Okay? To open it up.
Yes.
To allow the life force to come through.
That's right.
Now, I was like, what's a stent look like for real? It's like this scaffolding goes up in your arteries. I mean, on a very small scale, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
On a very small, very small scale. But the scaffolding is being built to open up that artery so that blood, the life force, can come through. Let that sink in for just a second. We take a lot of things for granted. Oh, you got an angioplasty. Okay. Oh, you had a stent put in. Oh, praise the Lord.
Ew.
Ew. Right. That's some serious stuff. Because once it's put in that scaffolding, so to speak, by that stent is built in there, it's in that place where you've got the trust that what you got going on is going to flow through. But God.
Yes.
But God. Who can be here and there and even in that blocked artery. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
Okay? Even in that scaffolding. So it really depends on what your scaffolding is made of.
Come on now.
Y'all with me?
Yes. Oh, come on now.
Does this make sense? Is this making sense to anybody?
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
So there's a couple of things that we have to do. You know, when you're about to have surgery, whatever, and you go into the doctor's office and they try to explain it to you, they give you a little pamphlet, you know, he reaches on the back and the stack of stuff and hands it to you, and you're supposed to go home and read it, and you're supposed to be ready. Okay. We're ready. So when we're getting ready, I would imagine, haven't been through anything like that, praise Jesus, but I would imagine that a lot of stuff is going through your mind. I need to have it done, but I'm scared, but I need to have it done, but I'm fearful. I need to have it done, but I'm not sure, is this the right person to do it? I better go get a second, third, fourth, 15th opinion, because I need to have it done. And meanwhile, you got this pain. Why do we reserve that just for our physical being?
Amen.
What about our emotional and mental well-being?
Amen.
Okay, we got this stuff. I need to get a second or third opinion. Should I really follow God? How come you even need another opinion?
Come on.
If God said it, God's going to get you through it.
Yes.
When you know God has called you to something, just do it.
That's it.
Just do it. Be about it. When you know God has purposed in your heart to speak to a certain someone, just do it. Okay, maybe this is for some other people. Is it?
No.
Or is it for you?
Good word.
Okay? Because a lot of times, we want to bargain with God. God, if you just do this, I'll just do that. Right? All right? Come on, you do it. Don't let me think I'm the only one. God, I imagine the other night in the World Series, a lot of people. God, if you just let us win, I'll be in church on Sunday. How many Cubs fans we got? Just making sure y'all are in church on Sunday. Right?
Yeah.
We do that.
Yeah.
When we know something works, but yet we're afraid, we're doubtful to step into it. But we know it works. I want to encourage you this morning. Fear not.
Yes.
Fear
Amen.
Not.
Amen.
Whatever that thing is, fear not.
Amen.
Fear not.
Yes.
Fear not. Sometimes we need to call things what they are. All right? We make a lot of excuses. Oh, that's just heartburn. I'm back to the heart analogy now. Physical heart. Oh, that's just heartburn. Oh, that was pizza. Oh, that was, you got a clogged worry, and you need to get up in there and get that thing fixed.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Doctor Dunn said it, and you were like, oh, he can't be right. I get this every time I eat pizza. We make excuses. You see what I'm talking about?
Yes.
We make excuses for things. We make excuses for people. Let that sit there for a second. We make excuses for people. Oh, they're like that. Really? We make excuses for people. We make excuses for one another. Well, you know she like, he likes. Well, every time that happens, we make excuses for people. And we don't hold ourselves or them accountable. If you're saying you trust God, then let me see you trust God.
Yes.
How about let's do something different today and let's just trust God.
Yes.
Okay, I'm sure in Savannah, Georgia, there were 1,500 other things to do this morning. But you found yourself here.
Yes.
In this place. Okay? Because you, I'm thinking, this is a stretch, correct me if I'm wrong, you're trusting God.
Yes.
For something. So why is it when we're trusting God for something, we're ready to look for the answers in every other place?
Mm-hmm. Come on now.
But God.
Come on.
Trust God.
Yes.
Trust God. Call things what they are. How about something you've been working on and you wearing yourself out working on it? Why don't you make that confession? I ain't been trusting God. I've been trying to do it in my own will and my own power. I ain't trusting God.
Come on.
No, but you're a believer. You're a Christian. You do it. You go to church every Sunday. You not picking on the praise and worship team. You singing the praise and worship. You the usher. You the meet and greet. But be honest with yourself and everybody else. I haven't trusted God.
Yes.
I haven't trusted God. I haven't trusted God. Scripture says, confess your sins one to another and you will be healed.
Yes.
You already raised your hand, you want to be healed.
Yes.
Confess your sins one to another and you will be healed. It's an area you're not trusting God to lead you on that path to keep you from getting hit by the cactus and the low branches. Sometimes we got to admit some things to ourselves. Okay, that may be the hardest thing. We laugh and joke about it with everybody else. Right? But I'm talking about in your mirror work in the morning. Things that we don't trust God for. Awareness is everything. Okay? Okay? And, you know, this is not about... So don't walk up out of here and say, Pastor P said, I need to point out your stuff you're not trusting God for. Pastor P didn't say that.
That's right. Amen.
I didn't say that. Because sometimes it's easier to see it in other people than it is ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But how about the very thing that you're seeing in other people might be the very thing that's messing with you?
Come on, man.
Exactly.
And everybody sees it on you, but they just being nice and not saying nothing.
Come on.
Awareness, self-awareness, okay? Self-awareness. Let the life force flow through you.
Amen.
I double dog dare you. How about a possibility when things we believe in on, but we attach stuff to it. Mm-hmm. We attach stuff to it in our bargaining with God. Okay? And we're like, God, I'm doing everything I know how. You need to get on to this. God, I'm doing it. You see me over here praying. You see me over here singing. You see me over here reading your word. You see me, you see me, you see me. God says this, my sister said a while ago, and the smallest act of obedience. You take one hyper small step of obedience, the blessings of God come rushing.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
rushing at you.
Yes, it does.
You know what God's told you to do.
Yeah.
You know what God's told you to do. Put that Reese's peanut butter cup back. You know what God has called you to do. You know. You know. Right? You've been glaring at that chocolate chip cookie recipe all week. I'm making these. You know what God's called you to do. Deviled eggs and shrimp. Y'all better stop. Aggressive Facebook post. Right? We be posting things subliminally. They on my friend list. I know they gonna get it. I'm gonna get them.
Good word.
And they gonna know now.
Right?
We do that stuff. Come on. And don't be, we gonna pray away a spirit of lying up in this house. Ourselves, because God don't pull no punches. God don't throw no shade. Okay? God's already told you. Okay? If somebody else comes up to you and says, God told me to tell you no, you know what I want to do. Wrong. If God wants you to know something, God will tell you God said.
Yes, he will. Amen.
And how about a possibility? He already has.
Right.
He already has. Stop waiting on 15 confirmations. Right? We wait. Oh, Lord, if there's a billboard on I-95 and it's a whatever, 311, Lord, I'll know then it was you. You know the voice of God. Follow him. Follow him. Follow him. Follow him. You know the voice of God. Follow him. And I'm serious about paying attention to these kids. You know what I'm saying? You know, a child will teach you some things about yourself. They will call you on your stuff.
Yes, they will.
Okay? Because like I thought about it when I thought, you know, I've tried to, okay. Tried to preach from my phone. I've tried to preach from my iPad.
Yeah!
I know, it's crazy, baby. I know. But my grandson, even whenever I listen to different songs on the radio, he'll be like, Pima, you're old school. All right, little seven-year-old. Right? Pima, you're old school. And I'm like, old school's not bad school, y'all.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
I took care of my Bible, okay? Okay? But I want to share that with you because the latest, hottest thing may not be the greatest, hottest thing.
That's right.
Okay? Because for 1995, you too, at 2 a.m. when you got QVC or something on the TV, you can get two for 1995 of something to heal you from fear, doubt, and take a pill. Right? There's a pill for this and a pill for that. How about at 2 a.m. call on Jesus? How about at 6 o'clock in the morning when you get ready to go to work and you know who's going to be there when you get there? You call on Jesus. How about the possibility when the doctor does give you a not so favorable diagnosis that you just right there in the doctor's office, doctor, you and me, we're going to call on Jesus. How about the possibility of that? Or whenever you go to that ATM. Mm-hmm. You know there ain't nothing in there. But just possibly that particular check didn't clear. You better call him Jesus. Okay? already in everything, every part of your life, every part of our existence. God is already there.
Right.
He's there when your kids get on your last nerve.
Yes.
He's there when they're telling you a truth and calling you out. Come on.
Yeah.
Y'all pay attention to these babies. They will tell it like it is. Why? Because they haven't, praise God, they never feel or come to realize the filters that we have had to generate and wrap ourselves in to be able to exist each and every day.
Yep.
Right? We got, I'm not exempt, we got plaque buildup, y'all. We got plaque buildup. We need a Holy Ghost angioplasty to open up some things in our life. Why? Because some things have been hurt. People said this. People said that. This happened to me. Pastor P, you weren't there. You don't know. But God. That's all I got, y'all. But God. You can trust all these other sources and all these other things. But God. But God. But God.
I'm
trying to look at each one of you. Because I know that I know that I know. Because we're a lot more alike than different. Y'all better know that. We've been through some stuff together. We've been through some stuff separately. But God.
Yes. Yes.
But God.
Yes.
But God. Even if you're going through right now, even if someone who has your heart is going through something right now, but God.
Hallelujah.
But God. Share with them. Say, I'm here to share some Holy Ghost angioplasty. I'm here to be a Holy Ghost jumper cable for you. I'm here to bring back a life force inside of you. I'm tired of listening to you talk about dead talk. I'm tired of you not trusting God to be God.
Yes.
I'm tired. I'm tired. CNN ain't got nothing on the GOP. The scripture says, and the ones that I have listed here, I'm just going to shoot them out at you, okay? But here it is. It speaks about out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
Yes.
So it's about the goodness that you fill up your heart so that your mouth can speak goodness.
Yes.
Okay? Godness. Come on.
Come on.
Right? It's about opening up your heart. The scriptures say in Proverbs that it is a life force.
Yes. Your heart.
It is the life force, y'all. The life force. I don't know about you, but that tells me I need to fill it with something good.
Amen.
Something like life. If there be dead places in your life right now. Y'all think I'm going to let y'all out of here in us non-dresses? That ain't the way we roll up in here.
Right.
If there be dead places in your life, blocked stuff, plaque in your heart, doubt, fear, worry, it's time for a Holy Ghost jumper cable.
Yes.
It's time for a Holy Ghost angioplasty.
Yes.
A stent of faith to be infused in that blocked artery.
Yes.
And opened up. Build with the scaffolding of faith and trust. How about some of that? And just some respect for life.
Yes.
Waking up every day, no matter what the bank says, and desire life. Wake up and just say life. Don't let it just be a confession. I love to come here and do the confessions of faith. I love that. Don't just let it be a Sunday morning thing.
Come on now.
Amen.
How about before your feet hit the floor? Life.
Yes.
Life. Life. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God, for being the source of life. Thank you, Jesus, for being the author and the finisher of our faith. I thank you, God, that you have purpose, Lord God. You gave us a choice. Your word says in Deuteronomy, you gave us a choice. Behold, I set before you life and death. Choose life.
Yes.
Lord, we could go in and out of every day full of dead things, death, doubt, worry, fear. It's a choice. And Lord, forgive us when we have become comfortable. comfortable clothing ourselves in fear and doubt and worry. Forgive us when we have done that. Forgive us when we became comfortable with it. We're used to them thorns. Oh, that thorn ain't nothing. I'm used to that. Forgive us when we got used to the bad stuff. And blocked the good stuff from coming through. Forgive us, Lord. Father God, if there be anybody in the house, Lord, needing a Holy Ghost jumper cable, needing a stint of faith in their life, every head bowed, every eye closed, I'll be honest, I can't really see with the lights. This is between you and God. This is you and a testimony to God. Every head bowed, every eye closed, you need a stint of faith infused in your heart. Just lift your hand, just lift your hand. Just lift your hand, just lift your hand. Just lift your hand. Thank you, God. Put those hands down. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And if you got a praise for the Lord, lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. The place where God infused life when you didn't think it was possible. Thank you, God. God, I ask now, Lord God, Lord, as we offer our praise, our offering of praise to you, Lord God. Lord God, that those hearts that need a stint of faith, I'm asking you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to turn this into a Holy Ghost operating room. Lord, if they need a stint of faith, Lord, hands on their hearts, Lord Jesus, and just believing, God, that you're opening up arteries. You're opening up in their mind. Sometimes our minds are blocked. Come on. Our hearts are blocked. Our ears are blocked. Come on, our bodies are blocked. God, I know I'm supposed to be doing this or that. I know, God, I need to go walk in every. I know. I ask you, God, to put the want to propel me to exercise, to eat right, to trust you, to speak faith, to speak life. God, right now, in the name of Jesus, every heart and home that is represented here, Lord, we speak life. Sometimes we need a stint of faith in our homes to open up places. We've talked about that before here. Where we go into that closet where we keep that thing in the back, in the dark, we think nobody can see, and God's looking at it and he's telling you it's time to throw that thing away, baby, because I got some life for you.
Yes.
We speak life. Speak life. Speak life. Speak life. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I speak life over every baby in this room. Lord, I plead your blood fresh on these babies, these children, Lord God. From the top of their head to the bottom of their feet.
Yes.
I speak life over them. Life in their school situation. Life in their parenting situation. Life in their just being kids situation.
Yes.
Protect them, Lord Jesus. Lord, use them to teach us.
Yes, Jesus.
Posture our ears toward the lessons you're trying to teach us through them. Jesus, today we choose life. We choose life. I rebuke and renounce the spirit of fear out of this room, out of our hearts. If there be any doubt, any worry, we rebuke that in the name of Jesus. In the powerful name of Jesus. If anybody's trusting God for anything, we got to take an act of faith. I'm going to ask you to stand to your feet. If you're trusting God for anything, trusting God for anything, stand to your feet. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. And Father, I pray that we each be a testimony to the other. Now we can see we're not alone. Now we can see we're not alone. Other people are trusting you, God, also. Other people are trusting you for healing, for faith, for the things that you said that we should be doing anyhow. But God, I just can't. God, you know. You know. God, we've been in this relationship for so long. And God, I don't know what I do. Without them, Folks, it's time to stop worrying about what other people think.
Come on.
And worry about what God thinks.
Yes, that's it.
This is the most powerful relationship you have between you and God. Amen. Let's get that one right. Because I will tell you, I stand here and testify. You put God first, seek God first, all these other things will be added unto you.
Yes.
That's not the gospel according to Pastor Pete, that's the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Matthew, you need to look it up.
All
these things will be added unto you. But you got to trust God first. Anybody in here can trust God?
Yes.
Anybody in here want to trust God?
Yes.
All day, every day.
All day, every day. I love you. And I praise God for you. And I pray that God seal the work that's done in this house this day. And I'm going to tell you something. We're not going to have a long, drawn-out altar call. You are the altar call.
Yes.
You know the need.
Yes.
You know the need. God's calling. As you're standing in proxy, I'm going to ask you, if you feel so comfortable doing it, putting your hands on your heart, in proxy for your pastor and Elder Erica, Maya, Mariah, and Micah, the pastor and her family. Father God, we offer our hearts to them. We extend our hearts to them. Cover them completely, Lord. Talk about a new, bold step of faith. Lord God, as they have stepped boldly into our world, Lord God, empower us. Empower us. Whatever needs you need us to help meet for them, let us be about it. Let us be about it. God, as they're taking this time, cover them completely with your love, with your strength. Lord, if there be any healing, Lord, needed, Lord, let it be swift and thorough. We thank you for bringing Maya into the world. Lord God, let us be an example of your presence, Lord God, to her, and all these other babies in here. And the church said amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. I love you completely, and I'm excited to be here. I love coming to Agape. You guys are our heart. Yeah, we talk about you. Your ears better be burning.
Yes.
We talk about you from coast to coast. I love you. Please give a shout out to your pastor.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
Give them a gift by loving one another completely.
Yes.
Okay?
Amen.
Now I'm going to ask you to do something for your neighbor. All right?
Yeah.
And I know this is pretty and soft music, but you know I don't roll like that, right? Turn to your neighbor. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor.